Hello everyone! Now I am going to show you how to get out of a situation where you have to make something out of handmade tools. Even my beast, Monia, is feeling the change in the weather. Winter is retreating and the heavy frosts will soon be over, but the off-season is coming, when the day gets warmer, but at night it is still very cold, so today's idea is very useful. You'll need any pipe with a suitable diameter. I have a stainless steel flue pipe with a diameter of 120 millimeters. At the bottom of this pipe you need to make some cuts. I divided it into 8 equal parts and made these cuts with my cordless angle grinder. It's faster than a handsaw. You can try metal shears if you have them around. Later you will see what the notches on the pipe are for. Just a few minutes of work and it's done. For me, a cordless lathe is the most essential tool. You can do any job with it. Everyone should have one in their shop. You've probably all seen a cable like this. It's very cheap and easy to buy anywhere. It is not a simple electrical wire. It has some very soft but strong hairs inside. With a small piece of tubing, this tassel can be connected to the electrical wire into a very strong connection. And you can put a jumper on it or just wrap some blue tape around it. I decided to test this wire and its possibilities in an unusual way. How else could it be used? Is it possible to boil water this way? I poured room temperature water into a clear glass and lowered my improvised heater into it. I plugged it in, but not into an outlet, but into a 12-volt power bank. Then I plugged it into a car charger. It would be great to be able to heat water in the absence of electricity. And voila, miracle! Look! The water started heating up. It even started making strange noises. Finally, the water came to a boil. Look how beautifully the water moves in the glass at different temperatures. We boil water every day and don't notice such a magical process of bubble formation. I did a lot of experiments with the wire and the tubes were just not enough for everything. I found another interesting way to connect electrical wire. I took some copper wires from the same wire, put them on top of each other and wrapped the connection tightly. It turned out to be strong and with good contact. Can this wire help me as a driver? I decided to attach a small piece to the windshield wiper of the car. They are always freezing and it is very annoying. I carefully glued the cable directly to the wiper rubber and will go outside to try it out. You can also do a heated windshield washer fluid in the car, which always freezes for some reason. To get the tests right, I did everything outside at about -5 degrees Celsius. I covered the windshield wiper very tightly with snow and even crumpled it up a bit, as if the snow was stuck. Then I turned on the heater and waited to see what would happen. Great! After a while, the wiper melted like a snowman. I found the best and easiest way to attach it. Just put a piece of copper tubing on the wire and squeeze it with pliers. All you have to do is solder the wire to the copper tubing. I use this cool red heat sealant to hold the wire in place. It can withstand temperatures up to 343 degrees Celsius. It dries pretty fast, which I like. And the dispenser that comes with it will help me use as little as possible. I will wind two cables in parallel to double the power. Calculating power, length, and voltage is based on the formula in the cable manual. Approximate calculations for 220 volts and for 12 volts are on the screen. I use two parallel lengths of 9 meters, which is only 320 watts, like a powerful laptop charger. I wanted to cover the top of the cable with plaster for better heat transfer and distribution, but I couldn't find it at the nearest store. The good thing is that I bought a plaster bandage at the local drugstore, which is used to fix broken limbs. I decided to use it. It was even more convenient. I just wet it, wrap it in two layers, and that's it. The whole job took no more than 5 minutes. My neighbor had a jar of universal putty he didn't need, and I used it for a nicer and denser finish. It did not take much. I used about 0.5 kilogram. Look how easy it is to apply. Just two boxes on each side, and in the middle is a stick from a floor scrubber. I didn't intentionally try to make the coating smooth. I wanted such a cool heater to be original and look like a stick from a tree, and its coating looks like tree bark. Time to finish it. I had a great idea. I first coat it with reflective varnish as a reflector. Then I sprinkle magic powder through a fine mesh. And then another coat of lacquer on top. This is a new product manufacturer, and I will definitely let you know if it is worth using or not, so you don't fall for inferior products. I wanted the wood look too bad, but the stencil did not fit and I had to putty everything. Friends, look. Spring is coming and I have a much needed powerful thing like this. I wanted a small size so that it is convenient to store and use, but at the same time with the function of self-priming water. Not only will it save a lot of money on car washes, but it will always be clean your car and motorcycle equipment, paths, fence and house facade, boat and ATV, barbecue and pool, cultivator and garden tools. And if anything, you can chop fruit. Of course, I will share the link to this car wash with you. Finally, a test. First, before we plug it in, let's turn off the lights. Wow! What a beauty! The magic powder works. It starts up very quickly, and this is clearly visible on the thermal imaging camera. It uses very little as it heats up to 80 degrees Celsius. There's a stream of hot air coming out of the tube from the top without using a fan. It is impossible to burn yourself. It is easy and quick to make. Also, make a heated greenhouse and eat fresh vegetables and herbs before anyone else. Or in general to make heated ventilation. If you like the video, then I would be grateful if you share it on any of the social networks. My friends will be interested, and for me it will be a good motivation to make other interesting videos. See you in the next video, friends.